Okay, I had a question about 7.62-53 rimmed video I did about the other day about the Lapua brass, I guess. And he was wondering about what the big difference between the 53 and the 54 is, and I think something to do with how it has to do with like reloading. So basically, I'll tell you how the way I understand it, and if anybody knows better, then you can leave comments. But it's more or less just what the Finns called the cartridge. The Russians, I guess, more or less called it the 54 rimmed. The Finns called it the 53. I think it mostly has to do with the way they loaded their cartridges, and that some of their earlier models, like the 1939 or M39 Mosins that they built, had a tighter barrel on them for some reason. So they put sort of like a 308 or 309 groove diameter barrel, where the Russians leaned more towards a 310, 311, 312, and up anywhere up from there. So the Finns would load their ammo with like a smaller bullet than what the Russians more or less did. But then I guess they sort of got into trouble when they got into the Winter War, where some people with the earlier Finnish models were trying to shoot Russian ammo, and they got sort of higher pressure problems, which would cause, I guess, extraction issues and stuff. Because the Russians, I think, more or less kind of loaded a 310 or a 311 bullet most of the time, I guess, to sort of compensate for some of the bigger bores that some other guns had. Where a lot of the ammo you encounter now is like around 309 or so, it seems, but all this newer surplus is like more or less geared towards, you know, basically post-war, you know, peacetime kind of guns, more or less. And they have tighter tolerances, I suppose. But so anyway, that's kind of what the Finns just use, a smaller bullet. The shells, like this one here, measures about pretty much 53 millimeters long. There's not a big difference in the case dimensions, it doesn't seem, between the Finnish one. There's like a Norma, that'd be Swedish. It's a Finnish military round. Igman, which is from Bosnia. Hungarian, Russian, Chinese, or another Hungarian round. They're all, if you compare them all, the shoulders are in pretty much the same spot. The case lengths seem to vary a tiny little bit. Like this one's about 53. I think the Igman is at like 53.5. So 54 more or less seems to be the maximum. Like most, I think pretty much even all the Russian stuff is a bit under 54. It's better to have a little shorter shell than a longer shell, because if the shell gets too long, then you can run into problems in your hand loading. But the shoulders are fairly similar, but they're, with a round like this, where the shoulder is, it doesn't really matter a whole lot, because it's a rim round, so the headspace is on the rim. When you fire it, the shoulder will blow forward. And that's the only real big thing you have to worry about if your gun is like Russian and has an excessively, like a longer chamber than normal. Because I know I've had like several like 9130s, and you can fire and shell in one gun, it'll chamber in a bunch of the other ones, but then there's a few that you can't close the bolt, because the chamber is either shorter or the headspace is tighter or something like that. But the shoulder bumps up in the chamber before you can close it. But so if you have a gun that has a fire a shell, find out where your shoulder is, and maybe your first loading with brand new brass, sort of use a moderate middle of the road kind of load or something like that, just so you don't, you know, blow the shoulder out ridiculous like. That'll work your brass more than you want and shorten its life. But I run into that with other brass, like the 8x50 LaBelle and stuff. So the stuff the Serbs make, the brand new brass, is the shoulder is way, way back, and when you fire it, it blows out like big time. But that's the way most rim shells are. They don't, like most of the military style ammo stuff, they'll load it so the shoulder is back far enough that the cartridges will work properly in guns that are getting a little bit dirty or stuff like that. But if you're going to hand load, then you can sort of, you know, use a cast bullet load to sort of nudge the shoulder forward. Then you can neck size, and your brass will last way, way longer, because This cartridge has a very, very good shoulder on it. It's fairly steep compared to some, like, you know, 303 and stuff are known for not having a very good shoulder, and they don't, shells don't normally last as long. But so far as that goes, that's pretty much the only thing we're precautioning worry about. And if you're loading for like the earlier model Finnish Mosins, and you can probably get away with a 308 bullet, but most Russian guns. But anyway, just slug your bore and you can find out what your gun will like. Most Russian guns you can get away with like a 311, 312 diameter bullet, where are the Finnish ones, you probably want to stay away from the bullet that big. So, but anyway, hopefully that makes sense or is useful, and we'll talk to you later.